What were you like at the University of North Texas that got a you got a full scholarship to play football there? What were you like in your days?
Highly competitive, Rich, but you know, that was big back when North Texas was a Division II school. They're Division I now.
Uh-huh.
We were out there running 40s, and I came from, you know, junior college. And in high school, I was a running back and a linebacker.
Mm-hmm.
And I wasn't fast enough to run around you, so I ran over you. And so we're out there running 40s, and Corky Nelson was our coach at North Texas. And we're out there running, and my last name used to be Williams.
Mm-hmm.
And he's got this perplexed look on his face. He goes, "Williams, come here." And I said, "Yeah, coach, what do you want?" He goes, "You're running a 4.9. I said, "Yeah, I always run a 4.9. He goes, your coach at Wharton said you ran a 4.7. I said, "Coach, I ain't never run a 4.7 in my life." "Williams, get out of here." So I was that guy from me to you, quickest guy on the team, if there's a sandwich or a beer involved, you know. But once you start stretching out past that, I blew my ACL out on a kickoff coverage about the third game of my junior season, spent all season rehabbing, came back and started all 11 games next year at weak side defensive end. A little undersized, you know, started, not really a disciplined player.
Yeah.
And as much as I love football and pro football, hell, I wasn't even close to making a grade.
Okay, so the most talented athlete you were ever in the ring with would be who?
Man,
where like, okay, this person can really move around, or this person can really do this, or whatever.
Ron Simmons.
Why is that?
Ron was a two-time All-American at Florida State University, defensive tackle. I mean, why he didn't play pro football, I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
But that guy, they still know who Ron Simmons is at Florida State. And then you could go to, you know, Kurt Angle, who won a gold medal in the 96 Olympics with a broken neck. And then from a strength standpoint, Mark Henry, the world's strongest man, I mean, he's legitimately the world's strongest man. So guys like that, there's so many physical specimens in that line of work. It's unbelievable.
Yeah, right. Well, obviously, you're one of them. I mean, who named you Steve Austin? Where'd you come up with that?
I was Steve Williams in Dallas, Texas, when I was getting my start. I went to Tennessee.
Mm-hmm.
The booker was a guy named Dutch Mantell. I drove my 1988 Hyundai Excel over there to the Mid-South Coliseum, and I walk into – I've been in business 3 months, and I walk in, and back in the old days, there was a guy from University of Oklahoma named Dr. Death Steve Williams.
Mm-hmm.
So I couldn't use that name because it would cause confusion on the card. So Dutch Mantell looks at me and says, "All right, you're Steve Austin." And I said, "Well, I don't want to be Steve Austin because I had respected the $6 million man. And I didn't want to copy that."
Sure.
So he goes, "You got 15 minutes to come up with a name." So 15 minutes goes by. I couldn't come up with nothing. He says, "You're Steve Austin." I said, "No." He goes, "You got 5 minutes to come up with a name." This is right before I'm fixing to go out, Rich. You know, your last name, your whole name has a big effect on your career.
Of course.
So finally he says, you know, basically get your ass out there. You're Steve Austin. And that's how I got it.
That's how – so it has nothing to do with the fact that you're from Austin? That literally
no, and I always said I was from Victoria, Texas, which is a town I used to live in.
Okay.
But if I would have said Steve Austin from Austin, Texas, you know, too redundant, no real panache or ring to it. So
uh-huh. –
When I finally came up with that Stone Cold Steve Austin thing, I told him, I said, I want to be from Victoria, Texas, because I wanted to be opposite of everybody else who wanted to be from a big city, you know, and with a lot of glamour to it.
Ah, so that's how it's kind of
well, Victoria, Texas had a little bit of je ne sais quoi to it, and all of a sudden it's like, hey, man, that sounds kind of cool. Where is it?
Well, I understand because, I mean, if there's a similarity here, is that when I was first trying to get on TV, I had a resume reel from Northwestern School of Journalism, Medill School of Journalism. So I grew up, my parents still call me Richard, but I wasn't going to be a sportscaster, Richard Eisen. And the question was, you know, in high school, they were calling me Richie. And I'm like, here's Richie with sports. And then the one thing that definitely I wasn't going to go with Dick Eisen. I just wasn't going to go with that.
Yeah.
It's just, even though Enberg did very well with that name,
yes,
just didn't fit. So I went with Rich. And that was kind of it.
But there's got to be that kind of thing that you've – and so I'm looking at right there on your logo.
Right.
It looks right and sounds right.
It is right,
though. It is.
It is right.
For more of The Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live or download The Rich Eisen Show app.